Greetings. In this video we perform the 250H maintenance according to the maintenance program of the Solus 26XL using the do-it-yourself principle. There is a maintenance table in the user manual, which shows the maintenance procedures to be performed. If the user manual is in English or otherwise lost, the Finnish user manual can be downloaded from the web address below. Before starting the maintenance measures, make sure that your home workshop has the necessary spare parts, oils, tools, and the willingness to get your hands dirty. If the above are missing, I recommend contacting an authorized Solus service shop. Lubricate the grease nipples. The location of the nipples is shown on page 81 of the manual. Lubricate the external threaded part of the lift arm and the ends of the pull arms. Adjust the tire pressure aptly between 1.5 and 2.5 bars max. Bolt tension at the front 72 Newton meters, wrench size 18 millimeters. Nut tension at the back 130 Newton meters, wrench size 24 millimeters. Air filter cleaning. Blow air pressure 1.6 bars max. Cleaning the radiator grill. Cleaning the cooler. Coolant lower limit when cold. Coolant level. The lower limit of the coolant when hot. When the engine is running warm, do not open the cap of the radiator system. When hot, the cooler is pressurized and opening the cap involves the risk of burns. Remove the oil filler cap. Remove the oil sump drain plug from the left and right side, wrench size 22 millimeters. Remove the oil filter by turning it counterclockwise. Lubricate the seal of the new filter with clean engine oil. Screw the filter in place clockwise. When the gasket touches the engine body, open it 1/3 of a turn and tighten again. Attach the left and right sump drain plugs. Add 4.2 liters of new engine oil from the oil filler opening. Attach the oil filler cap. Start the engine at idle. When the oil light goes out, you can turn off the engine and check the engine oil level. If necessary, add more engine oil. Place the locking pliers lightly on the fuel supply line to prevent fuel from leaking during the filter change. Open the fuel filter by turning it counterclockwise. Remember to lubricate the seal of the new filter. Attach the filter in the same way as the oil filter and remove the locking clip. While bleeding the fuel system, keep the ignition key in the ON position. Fuel filter vent, wrench size 13 mm. Bleeding of the injection pump, wrench size 12 mm. Start the engine and let it idle. When the engine is running normally, you can turn it off. Start cleaning the magnetic filter by using the front loader to raise the front end of the tractor as high as possible. Place supports of a suitable height under the front wheels and place the front end on them. Put the oil pan under the filter, open the front hose connectors. Slide the rubber cones forward, the oil will flow out. Remove the finger locking ring from inside the filter body. Pull out the inner part of the filter and temporarily put the rubber cone in place. The filter has worked because there is a mixture of oil and metal here. Clean the magnetic filter with a clean cloth. Assemble the magnetic filter to its body in the reverse order. Measure the amount of oil that has spilled out and add the same amount of new oil. Wrench size 24 mm. Lower the front end of the tractor and check the amount of gear oil. Add oil if necessary. The oil level is in the middle of the marks. Also clean the hydraulic system breather. Raise the front loader and lock it in the upper position with the safety device provided. Open the front axle oil filler cap, as well as the inspection caps on both sides, key size 16/13 of a millimeter. Open the three oil drain caps, key size 13/10 of a millimeter. front axle oil drain caps. After the oil has drained out, fasten the drain plugs. Attach the oil fill pump hose to the hole in the inspection cap on the left side. Add new oil 0.5 L. Do this on the right side as well. Attach the oil fill pump hose to the front axle oil fill hole. Add new oil to 1.7 L. When the oil level has settled on both sides of the front axle, check the oil level and add more if necessary. Also, clean the front axle breather. Perform a test drive to test the operation of the controls. Check and adjust clutch and brake pedal clearances, page 74 of the manual. Towards new challenges. This is how to make a simple filter key. You need a long socket, wrench 13 mm, for which grooves are made with a disc on both sides of the socket. The load sling loop moves freely in the sling. Take a 43 cm long piece of cargo cloth, put the ends together about 3 cm apart. Sew around the edges and crease in the middle. It will be a strong connection, so that this tarpaulin loop doesn't get out of place. A simple way is to load a 13 mm nut here. Fasten it on with quick glue. Another way is to make a hole in that and put a spring pin in the hole. If the Solus has a front loader, the filter key works perfectly in the tight filter hole. I made two adapters for the oil pump I used for the front axle oil change. A 4.5 mm hole is drilled lengthwise into the 8 by 20 mm hex screw. Let's put it in the hose that came with the pump. For tightening, you can use, for example, a lock ring of a suitable size from. The adapter is screwed into the hole of the front axle oil check plug. I made the second adapter from the metal tube that came with the pump. Cut off a piece of approximately 5 cm, make a 10 mm outer thread for it. Replace the adapter on the end of the hose. The adapter is screwed into the hole of the front axle oil filler cap. Remember to clean the adapters after working.